Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about error handling, and this is very important topic in SSIS. So let's start with error handling. Error might occur in SSIS package when we are extracting data from the source, or we are loading data into destination, or we are trying to perform some transformation. So this is because of unexpected data, and it's bad practice to fail the package when error occur. So how we can handle the errors? So here we have two ways to handle the errors. First, we can configure source, transformation and destination by using fail component, ignore failure and redirect flows. So we will discuss later in this video series. Next is by using on error event in error handler at the package level or task level. So we will discuss this in next video. So let's start with our first scenario. So here we have a scenario. We have a flat file source. So this is our flat file, and we want to extract data from this flat file and load into SQL Server table. As I have already created the table. So this is our table, and it has 5 rows as we are having in our flat file. First we will create our package. Once our package will be executed, then data should be loaded in this table. After that, we will create a custom error on the flat file, then we will handle that error. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package, then call this package as error handling. So this is our error handling, looks good. Now I need to use a data flow task. Now double click on this data flow task. So here I need to fetch data from flat file source, so we can drag and drop, and we want to load data into SQL Server table, so we have to use OLEDB destination. So double click on this flat file source. Here we need to make flat file connection manager, so we need to click on new. Here we need to select file name with folder. So this is our file, so we can click on open, then go to on columns. So looks good. Now go to on advance. In advance, as you can see, for ID we are having data type as string, so I need to change this data type with integer. Now click on OK. So we have done our connection manager. Now I need to click on OK. So we have done our source. Now we need to configure our destination, so we can connect with destination and double click on this OLEDB destination. It would ask for OLEDB connection manager, so click on new. As I have already made the connection, so I am going to use that one. Click on OK. Here we need to select the table where we want to load the data. So I want to load data in raw file table. So this is our raw file table. Go to on mapping. Mapping succeed. Looks good. Now click on OK. Now we can save this package and click on start. So package executed successfully. So 5 rows should be loaded in our table. Stop this package, go to on table, and now we can refresh. So data have been loaded successfully in this table. Now go to on flat file, and here I need to create a custom error. So in ID field, as we can see, we are having only integer values. So I need to change this integer value with alphanumeric values. So these two rows has alphanumeric values. Now we can cancel and go to on SSDT. So this time, once our package will be executed, then flat file source will be failed because we are not having integer values in ID field. Now we can click on start. So as we can see, flat file source failed. Stop this package. Now double click on this flat file source. Here we can see we have connection manager, then columns, then error output. In error output, we can see we are having error and truncate. So in error, if error will be occurred, then what we want to perform. So here we have three options. First is fail component, then ignore failure, then redirect rows. So first, as we have seen, fail component. If any error will be occurred in ID field, then that component will be failed. Second, ignore failure. So we can select ignore failure and click on OK. Now we can save this package and click on start. 5 rows should be loaded in our SQL Server table. Stop this package. Go to on table. Now I can refresh this table. And this time we are having these 5 rows. Once we are not getting proper data, as we have seen in our flat file, we are not having proper integer values. We have alphanumeric values. That's why that values will be replaced by null in our destination. So this is our destination. Now in our third option, we have redirect rows. So double click on this, go to on error output, and this time I would like to redirect rows to error output. Now click on OK. So we have done. I don't want to load data with any physical destination. I just want to check the data. So we can use multicast. Then I wish to connect with error output. And here it would load the data if we will not get proper data as we are expecting. Now click on OK. Here we can enable data viewer. Now we can save it. Click on start. So as we can see, 2 rows moved to error output. So this is our error output, and we can check the error description as well. So we are having data values cannot be converted reason of the incorrect data types. So 2 rows moved to flat file error output, and 3 rows goes to our destination. Now we can stop this package. Now go to on SSMS, and this time refresh this table. So 3 rows inserted in our table and 2 rows move to error output. So this is if we are not getting data as we are expected in terms of data type. Second, we have truncation issue. So go to on flat file connection manager, and here as you can see inside this column we are having all the columns. Then advance, we are having first name. So output width is 50. So I would like to change with 10. Now click on OK. Now double click on this flat files. OK. In error output, as we can see, truncation issue. In truncation, we are also having 3 options as we have seen in errors. First is fail component, then ignore failure, redirect rows. So I would like to use with fail component. If we are having more than 10 characters in first name, then our task will be failed. Now click on OK. Go to on flat file, and here I would like to increase the length of this. Save it and close. Now click on start. So our package failed. Now we can stop this package, and this time I would like to change with ignore failure. Now click on OK. Now we can execute our package. So as you can see, 5 rows goes to our destination. Now we can stop this package and go to our destination, and now we can refresh our table. And here as we can see, this is our record, and we are having only 10 characters. So in first name it will insert only 10 characters. If we are having more than 10 characters, then that data would be lost. This is our case 2 when we ignore the error. In our third, I would like to redirect rows to error output. Now click on OK. Save it and click on start. So here, so 1 row moved to error output, and we can see error description, data was truncated. Looks good. Stop this package. So I hope you have understand how we can handle the errors if error will be occurred in our package. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.